Hello guys, Gabriel here and welcome back to Clastify Tutorials, where we dive deep into the world of IB to empower and simplify your diploma program. Today's hot topic is a crucial one. How do word counts work in IB? Whether you're crafting an extended essay or writing your internal assessments, understanding word count requirements is key to success. And for detailed and full of insights on word count guidelines for each subject, don't forget to visit our blog, where we've prepared a series of posts detailing these specifications. Now let's get into the specifics of general requirements. The word count in the IB is a critical factor that students must obey across various assessments and subjects. This parameter serves not just as a guideline, but as a strict limit that defines the scope and depth of your work. Each subject within the IB curriculum has a specific word count or page limit that students must follow, ensuring that their submissions are concise, focused, and relevant to the topic at hand. Remember that it's the maximum length limit. Each of the assessments you'll write can be shorter. Word count limitations in the IB serve a dual purpose. Primarily, they challenge students to refine their thoughts and arguments to the most essential elements, promoting clarity and precision. Secondarily, these constraints prepare students for future academic and professional endeavors, where the ability to convey complex ideas into a concise manner is invaluable. While usually there's no explicit criterion penalizing students for exceeding the word count, it's critical to understand that the examiners will not consider any content beyond the limit. Important information placed outside these bounds could significantly impact your score. Here's the general rule of the IB's word count. Extended essay, EE, caps at 4,000 words, focusing on in-depth study and independent research. Internal assessments, IAs, vary by subject. Sciences, starting from May 2024, range up to 3,000 words. Some more explanation. The variability in word count requirements across different subjects in IB is thoughtfully tailored. As I mentioned in the introduction, we have a whole series of dedicated posts on our blog, so head over to Clastify to check the detailed information about each subject. Generally speaking, included in the word count, the introduction, body, conclusion, direct quotations, and basically any other core content. Excluded from the word count, the abstract, contents, page, maps, charts, diagrams, unnoted illustrations, tables, references, citations, footnotes, bibliography, and appendices. But beware here, because if you write additional information and extend any part of the text just because they are not included in the limit, and it'll be obvious what you did, the examiner will not take it under consideration and disregard it. However, nuances exist and it's vital to see Clastify's blog for detailed insights into each component. I'll leave a link to the series in the description. Exceeding the word count does not arouse direct penalties in the form of reduced grades, but the examiners are instructed to disregard any content beyond the prescribed limit, they will simply stop reading. This means that vital arguments, evidence, or conclusions presented past the word count threshold will not be considered, significantly hurting your final grade. Effective word count management involves more than just trimming excess words. It requires a strategic approach to content development. This includes prioritizing key points, employing concise language, and utilizing appendices for supplementary information where appropriate. Moreover, understanding what is included in the word count, such as quotations and citations, versus what is excluded, like appendices and footnotes, is crucial for accurate word count planning. As a tip, it's always easier to shorten something down than to extend it. Write everything like you'd normally do, and then, if you exceed the limit, cut those unnecessary filler words or shorten the sentences without changing the actual content. To give you an example, write to instead in order to, and it will already subtract two words. And if you have something like this in many places, the whole essay can be easily shortened by 100 to 200 words. It is always best to start with this shortening technique because it is the simplest way to meet the limit and it does not require changing the content. If it turns out not to be enough, the second step you should take is to find the elements that might be the least relevant and simply remove them. The word count in IB assignments requires a careful balance between comprehensive analysis and concise expression. Remember, the goal is to communicate your ideas effectively within the established limits. For more tips, subject-specific guidelines, and strategies to master the word count in your IB, head over to our blog at Clastify.com. We've got you covered with resources designed to guide you through every step of your IB coursework. If this video has been helpful, please give us a thumbs up, subscribe for more insightful content, and share this with your fellow IB friends. Until next time, keep writing.